This is 21st century. Go back.
I'm Mr. Woodley. I happen to be sixth grade science teacher, and I am a part of 21st Century. So 21st Century, for one thing, we tutor the kids that need the extra help automatically. So the first goal is to make sure education is the main part of it. But then we have our enrichment parts, and that's where the different clubs come in, like the step team and beat club and the different vendors that come by. And it gives the kids something to look forward to after they get on tutorials. So you can get an incentive going where, hey, we knock this out here, we get work done first, and we can go play and learn some things. And the things that we're teaching them in enrichment, those are things that actually can get the kids to make money that way after they graduate. Because if they stick with it, then they can be making money before they get out of high school and not have to worry about going through the traditional job circuit if they don't want to do that. So the kids get excited about these things. Like today, we first started Beat Club, and I'm teaching the students how to produce music, how to make their own music, and then at one point start making money from that particular music. So having that incentive of, hey, I can use my creativity, I brought something out of thin air, and I made it happen, and I can show somebody this, there's a pride that comes along with that. Same thing with like the step team with Mr. Boudreaux. Like when they're all together and they're stepping and they're in sync and they hear how that sounds, they get excited about it. You'll see it on their face. As soon as they finish, they know they got it right. So it's those types of things that builds up that confidence, because you know middle school is an awkward time for kids. So it builds that confidence in them to where they can walk around with that sense of pride, and that pride translates to the classroom with them being confident and getting their work done. Because now they know that, hey, I learned this in tutorials and enrichment, I can use that. Even something like Beat Club, they can make a beat, then use that particular beat to memorize something for a test, like I used to do, and take that, and now they're passing because they made a beat for a test. It sounds crazy, but those are things that we like to put inside their head to think outside the box. Don't just take this like it's just fun. No. Use it. It is fun, but use it. It's arts integration. Because what we'll do is, and I'm bringing this over into my science class, where we'll literally have a conversation about quarter notes and eighth notes, and then we'll apply that to something like density and how we can memorize what the density formula is. So those types of things really help. Because if they were just running around playing football, playing basketball all day, that's cool and all, that keeps them in shape. So we definitely want to have those types of things happen, but we want to have those little other small activities. And then we also have things like the book club, where we're getting kids to read. Most kids don't like reading in class, mainly because some of them don't read as fast, or they might have issues pronouncing certain words. Reading club, we get them comfortable with reading, and then they can start applying that to the rest of the classroom. So just integrating everything to where it can enrich the kids.
Right.
I've seen it work for us ever since I started last year. Like, I've seen students who became better students because they wanted to make sure they can do things in 21st century. Like, in our different clubs that we have, there's a certain grade average you have to even participate. Like my B club, you gotta have a 75 and above. We don't do low C's or nothing like that. We do 75 and above to be a part of B club. So that's already incentive to get that done. But at the same time, as I mentioned, them going forward and using these things to where they don't have to do traditional jobs, not everybody is meant to do certain things. Not everybody is meant to go to college, but everybody can be successful. So it's giving them options. And that's ultimately what every teacher and parent want for their child, is options. And that's what we're doing here. We're giving the kids options. We're giving them things that they can do and take with them. Because even if they go off away from Bailey and they have those 21st century values with them, they can still apply those things to whatever high school they go to or whatever job they go to after high school. It's that work ethic, that willing to learn, that trying to figure things out and think differently. Join 21st Century, okay? We out here making beats. We out here stepping. We out here making sure people can read. Not to mention, I know a lot of y'all want to challenge me in basketball, and I'm telling you right now, ask your 7th graders and 8th graders from last year. I got game. So if y'all want it, y'all can get it, okay? We out here.
My name is Mr. Boudreaux. I teach 8th grade math and Algebra 1. Well, you know, it started just being a young African-American male in the system, the school system, I mean. I didn't get that many teachers that looked like me. I wasn't able to get a lot of teachers that could relate to me, tell me about what's going to happen outside of these walls. As I went on to college and become an adult, I saw that there's a need for people giving back and working with young people. And so I decided to do that. Me and a friend of mine, we got together. We said, hey, we're going to give back. He's an engineer. I'm a school teacher. So we all work with, you know, kids, mentor, internships, things of that nature. And we just thought it'd be a good idea to bring it into the school. Oh, wow. I definitely feel it gives them a shoulder to cry on. And I know that sounds cliche, but it's really true. Like, a lot of the kids need that emotional support. I didn't believe it at first. I didn't want to, you know, kind of jump into the job, but it's really the basic nature, nurture, that kind of thing that the kids need. And with that missing, they're not able to learn. They're not able to feel comfortable. They're not able to trust in order to open themselves up to learn. So I saw that that was needed, and I said I can provide that in a professional setting, saying that, hey, not only am I your teacher, but I'm also here as somebody who's walked in your shoes, just trying to make the path for you a little easier.
It's a good experience. It has helped me a lot in school, bringing my grades up, you know, setting a good example for the newer kids just coming to school. It has matured me by a lot, by the way I dress, by the way I talk, you know. You look good, you feel good, you do good.
Oh, in so many different ways. They see people that look like them doing something in the field that they may like. I love being able to give them different avenues. I mean, I'm not going to be honest with you. It's not all about, you know, everybody doesn't have to go to college. Everybody's not going to say, I want to become a teacher. Everybody's not going to say, I want to be a doctor, a lawyer. But seeing an electrician, seeing somebody who's, you know, head of the maintenance around the building, seeing somebody who's a police officer, different type of job opportunities that's going to show that, hey, I can do that too if that's what I want to do. It's professional, it's positive, and it's uplifting. That's the most important thing. Wow, I would love for young men on campus to see the positivity that we bring. All right, on Tie Tuesday, that initiative is really important to me because it shows kids that the better you dress, the better you feel about yourself, the better you'll do. Okay, if you look good, you'll feel good. When you feel good, you'll do good. I really believe that, and so I love that initiative. I want kids to also feel the best about themselves. I want them to get the totality out of school, and that's not only learning, but that's making relationships, social relationships, and emotional relationships that allow them to become one whole person. So I think it'll be a good idea for them to see and experience and work with other people and build those relationships, so when they go out into the real world, they'll know how to be participants in the world and be able to go along with everybody.